Da'Kar to Nancia. Da'Kar to Alex.
Alex here. Go ahead.
Have you seen Nancia anywhere? She's not answering her comm.
Have you tried sickbay?
I was hoping that she wasn't there. I'll check there now.
Well, hurry. It's getting cold.
Will do. Da'Kar out. Nancia.
Da'Kar. I'm sorry, I didn't hear you come in.
Still trying to figure this thing out?
The more I try, the less I know. I still can't remember how I got here. I don't have any memory of...
Look, it's going to be okay. Besides, tonight is for getting you to take your mind off all this. Alex has a surprise for us.
This might not end well at all.
Come on, let's get going before anyone sees us.
Don't get me wrong, I think Alex is horrible, but...
He's human. I've noticed they take an almost obsessive interest in the relationships of others.
I haven't been around many humans before. They are a bit... Is the word nosy?
It's nosy, and I don't think they consider it as such. It's one of the many ways they interact with each other interpersonally.
And what do they get out of it?
Well, I think it makes them feel connected to those around them on a more personal level.
On a Klingon ship, you keep to yourself. I think.
You haven't told anyone, have you?
Of course not.
Have you talked to Dr. Salar yet? He's wanted you to stop by sickbay. He's curious to discover if there are any lasting effects on you after being in the stasis pod for so long.
I refuse to see that Vulcan. He's fairly annoying.
Well, he is a Vulcan. You have to understand that while he may come across as overly clinical, he's not a bad guy.
Alex, Dr. Salar, are there any other aliens you tolerate on this vessel?
Well, there is one other. Besides, Alex has had some insightful advice regarding our situation.
Since when do you listen to Alex for romantic advice?
Since he decided that he wanted to help us with this.
Why would he want to help us?
I honestly don't know. He calls me his best friend. I'm not even sure what that term means.
So, where are we going?
It's a surprise.
You know Klingons hate surprises, right?
Just relax. Nothing's going to bite you. Like I said, Alex's idea.
Is this really necessary?
He said something about a proper date being dinner.
The talk's supposed to be raw, but I can overlook that. What is that?
Zabul stew. It's quite a delicacy back on my home planet.
I don't understand how you could eat that stuff.
Well, your plate isn't appetizing either, Parmakai. You eat it raw?
We eat it while it is still alive. Actually, the stew is fine.
So let's eat before the blood wine gets cold.
It's really good.
You really should see Dr. Salar. I love you, but I also have a responsibility to duty. They need to know.
Know what? That I don't remember anything for coming out of stasis? Do you know what could happen if my father learned I had no memories from before I woke up? The situation could be dire.
This is a Federation Klingon crew. The captain will protect and support you. Your father will come round. And you really don't recall anything from before being in the stasis pod?
Nothing. I woke up, recognized on some level that call was my father, but as to how I got here or what I'm doing here, I just don't know.
It could be just a temporary memory lapse. Again, another reason to see the doctor. He may be able to discover how to unlock your suppressed memories. Have you noticed any other memories fading away? Or do you remember, well, everything since you got here? I mean, like, about us.
You are quite adorable.
Shh, keep it down. Your father is in his quarters next door, after all. We'll have to tell him soon, Palmer Kai.
Are you kidding? Father would never approve. And yes, I remember everything since I got here.
Listen to me, all right? I know if you tell him, he'll be happy for us.
All hands to battle stations. We've arrived, Kronos.
Sir, I'm detecting an unknown vessel firing on the planet's surface.
Drop cloak. Engage the enemy.
So much for the dinner date.